What's going on, guys? It's your boy Adjen, back again for another Cat Fantasy video. And for today, it's time for some Cat Waifu review. And this is going to be my very first time reviewing a Cat Waifu in this game called Cat Fantasy. And I'm gonna be reviewing Choco Shiro. Yeah, this one, the waifu here in my home screen, this is Choco Shiro. That's not really her name. She is called the Tactical Submarine Shiro. The costume sa Tactical Submarine, but as a waifu, her name is Shiro. She is, in my honest opinion, one of the best DPS in the entire game, in my honest opinion. Why? Let us take a look at her skill set. So, her ultimate skill, Protocol Destruction, deals 198% attack as dire damage to one enemy. Increases damage dealt to targets with debuffs to 2.5 times. So, dire damage is a kind of a new term in this game where it increases damage dealt to targets with debuffs to 2.5 times. So, she deals massive damage if you have inflicted a debuff on the enemy. And it's very easy to inflict debuffs on enemy. And especially if you've been playing long enough, it's very easy to time it this one, because you can just use it as your last card slot, or maybe just follow it up with the, once you inflict the debuff skill, then follow it up with her ultimate. Very easy to achieve this dire damage, and this one packs a lot of punch. It's very one of the best single target DPS in the entire game, in my honest opinion. Very strong. She is a natural SSR character, by the way. You can get her from the standard pool of summon, which is also really good, but we have a lot of SSR. we have a lot of SSR in the game, and starting her up might take some time. You also need to get lucky. Her skill 1, Protocol Charge, this is a single target damage. At 3 star max skill, this 150% attack as overload damage to one enemy. Overload damage is a deals 2 times damage to buff targets. So if the enemy has buffs, usually they always have buffs, especially enemies that has some shield. Shield is considered a buff. So she will also deal some overload damage to those kind of enemies. And as I've said, buffs are pretty much everywhere in the entire game. So she will always usually deal this much damage to the enemy. That is why she is very strong. Probably, if not the best single target DPS in the entire game. Her second skill, Protocol Maintenance. This is a buff skill. Self buff, by the way, increases this combatant's attack abilities by 15% for 2 turns at only 1 star card. At 2 star, 20% attack increase. At 3 star, 25% attack increase for 3 turns. Take note about that number of turns. Usually, this one is always the best, but if you cannot get this one, even this one is already pretty good enough. Especially if you're going to be going against some players in RTA, we have real-time arena in this game. So, buffing herself up with this one, follow it up with her skill 1, it's already a pretty good, decent combination. She can already, if you have a really powerful built Tactical Submarine Shiro, she can one-shot one character in the RTA. If you have an OP build around her. So yeah, she's very strong, very powerful, and also very kawaii. Her outfit, if you don't like the Choco version, you have the white version. Yeah, so it really depends on your own preferences, but I find her really gorgeous in this type of a costume here. Now, let's take a look at my Choco Shiro stats. As you can see, my stats here are kind of okay-ish. She's my very first level 60 character, by the way. You cannot ascend her anymore. So, level 60 is the maximum the maximum level that you can attain in your character. So as you can see, I have 3.7k attack. I have 55% critical rate, 149% critical damage. This one can still be improved. Yeah. Since she is a DPS character, you want to build her with a DPS build. Attack, of course, increasing the attack stat is the way to go. But also, take note on your crit rate to critical damage ratio. Usually, 1:2 is the best way, but I think it's pretty doable to obtain this kind of substats, because in equipment, you can refine the equipment. Equipment can be, as you can see here, my equipments are pretty nice, right? And as you can see, substat stacks. You can have 2 attack percent, or maybe even a complete substats of fully attack percent, which is nice. Really, really nice. You can refine this one by just refining them. Like, for example, here, let me refine something. This one, critical damage resist. I don't need this one. I'm going to be refining this one. Still crit resist, but it becomes purple, right? So, yeah, it's just expensive to refine the equipment, the substats. But as you can see, you can choose the substats that you want for your character. And Shiro is a DPS, so go for attack, critical rate, critical damage. Even you might want to consider armor penetration to give her more DPS output. But right now, I think the best stats to focus on are just attack, critical rate, and critical damage. Take note that the game is just on the early phase. It's only been a week since the game launches, so we still need to test out the characters on different kinds of game modes. But for my play testing with Shiro, I can attest that she is very, very strong, very, very powerful single target DPS. The only downside to her is that her AI sucks. Yeah, in auto battle, her AI sucks. If you've been playing for quite some time now, you know that how you might notice that how AI works in the game is that you have 4 characters in a team, right? And if you click the auto function of the battle, you're just doing auto battle, the AI will always use characters skill only once per round. So one skill per each character, which is a shame, because how to use Shiro is that you're going to be using her, buffing her self, and then using her other attacks, especially her normal attacks. So she buffs herself, then use her normal attack. But the AI, if you do the auto battle, the AI will always use the buff attack and then pick the other character's skills. It's very, very dumb. Very, very not really recommended for auto battle. That is probably her main weakness, her main downside. Her AI just sucks. But if you pilot her manually, she is very, very strong. Especially if you know what you're doing, if you know what you're tackling, she's very, very strong in the hands of a good player. But for the AI, she's meh. She's mid. Yeah, that is the only difference. There is a huge difference between manual pilot and then autopilot. Her Pathos weapon, by the way, you can unlock this one once you breach level 56. So, the last ascension. This one is a bit random. Her Pathos weapon is also really, really nice. As you can see here, increases combat attack ability 2.5. More additional stats for her, critical rate 7%. More attack, more DPS oriented for this one, but very, very expensive to upgrade. As you can see, there's a lot of critical damage to gain here. 14% and then 7% critical rate, and then some more attack stats. So my attack stat will still go up. This one can still go up even further. And also, I'm only using purple equipment. I haven't started farming the yellow equipment because I cannot clear that stage just yet. But we will get there. But for now, this one will do. The critical set is pretty much a really good starting set for her. You might want to consider for more damage, the critical damage set. There is a critical damage set, by the way. Where is it, that one? Do I have the, yeah, this one. So critical damage also gives you more critical damage percent. Maybe a mix and match. Just mix and match of to what is suited best for your build. Because not everyone has a good complete set of critical set. Not everyone has a complete set of critical damage. So mix and match until you get the desired stats that you're aiming for. Probably I can aim for more than 5k attack once I've already farmed the yellow gears. Also, once I've upgraded my Patas weapon, I can probably achieve more than that one. And probably it's also possible to obtain around 300% critical damage. That's just me, because right now we are just in the early phase of the game. We still haven't unlocked the full potential of any characters unless you're whaling or something like that. But yeah, I'm not a whale. I'm just a casual F2P player, full F2P in this game. So yeah, this is my very first cat waifu review. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section down below. And I think that's it from me for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please leave a like and subscribe. I'd really appreciate it if you could help me grow my channel more. And thank you to everyone who are supporting my channel. I appreciate every one of you. Until next time, peace.